Namaste. Today we are going to learn about women and print in the lesson Print Culture and the Modern World, Class 10. Till mid-19th century, girls were not allowed to go to school. This is how the situation was. This is how girls were treated during the mid-19th century. In most of the Hindu communities, girls were denied to go to school as they feared that they might become widows. Similarly, many Muslim families also did not permit the girls to get educated, fearing that they might become corrupted reading the Urdu romances. But all this changed after mid-19th century.
पापा, क्या मैं विद्यालय जाकर पढ़ सकती हूँ?
हाँ हाँ, अब जा सकती है। आज से लड़कियों के लिए भी पाठशाला स्थापित किया गया है, लेकिन अच्छे से पढ़ना है।
ठीक है पापा।
नाना, नेनु कुड़ी स्कूल के लिए चादर कुंतर नाना।
स्कूल के भी अक्सर लेने इनके उपाध्याय डस्टर बागा चादर को।
अलग है नाना।
This is how girls were treated after mid-19th century. Many liberal husbands and fathers started to send their girls to school, as this was the period during which many schools exclusively for girls came up.
Rebel women whose education was denied educated themselves and learned to read and write on their own. Here comes the first example.
मैं राज सुंदरी देवी हूँ. मुझे चैतन्य भगवत पढ़ना है, लेकिन मुझे पढ़ना लिखना नहीं आता. क्या करूँ मैं?
बेटा, इधर आओ और आकर इन्हें पढ़ो. मेरे साथ बोलना. इसे कहते हैं आ
आ
आ
आ
ई
ई
ई
ई
ऊ
ऊ
ऊ. आज के लिए ये काफी है, हम कल और सीखेंगे.
ठीक है पापा.
ओ, ये आ है, ये ई है, ये ऊ है.
Like this she learned how to read and write on her own and also wrote her first story known as Amar Jivan. It was the first autobiography of a woman in India. Here comes the another example of Rukia Shakawat.
Bhai, main angrezi seekhna chahti hu.
Nahi, tum angrezi nahi seekh sakti ho, tum urdu seekho.
Nahi nahi, main angrezi hi seekhungi.
Urdu seekhne se tum Quran pad sakti ho, tum angrezi nahi seekh sakti ho.
Rukia learned English on her own and also wrote her novel known as Sultana's Dream. She supported women's education.
The opponents of female education say that women will become unruly. They call themselves Muslims and yet they go against the basic tenet of Islam, which gives women an equal right to get educated.
Some women reformers supported women education. Let's see some examples.
I'm Kailash Bashnidev. I'm against the ways how women are imprisoned at home, made to do hard domestic labor and kept in ignorance. It is very pathetic. So let me write more about them to support them.
I'm Pandit Ramabai. I'm really angry about the miserable lives of the upper caste Hindu women, especially the widows. I'll do my best for the livelihood of those widows and let me build a home to accommodate them.
I'm Tarabai Shinde. I do want to write about women.
Now let's see how vernacular languages influenced women.
Vanakkam. I am Lakshmi, a Tamil novelist. Most of the women in the world are confined by social regulations. Their world is very small. They get happiness only through reading books.
Namaskar. Hindi printing began in the year 1870. Many writing issues arise like women's education, widowhood, widow remarriage and national movement. Women likes to read short stories and serialized novels in Hindi.
In Punjab, Ramchandra Publications published a book called Stri Dharma Vichar to teach women how to be obedient wives. The Khalsa Tract Society also published cheap booklets with same message.
In Calcutta, the Patala Publications published variety of books. The peddlers used to sell those books.
Patala books, Patala books! Patala books, each one Patala books! Each one.
So hope you have learned about print and women and print. Thank you.